In this video, I'm going to share how to optimize your Instagram bio for your business profile. I'm Crystal Velkaitis. I've been teaching social media to retailers for over 10 years, and I've got some super simple tips for you to make your bio stand out on Instagram. So first of all, we want to make sure that you're using some emojis in the bio that relate to the products that you sell. This is a great way to add some color and help make your bio stand out. We also want to make sure it just sounds like you, it's authentic to you, and do the best that you can because you only have 150 characters, but we just want to really talk about who you are in your voice and in your tone. And I recommend having a call to action in the bio. So it might be click to save $10 if you're linking to a place where people can save 10 bucks. They can give their email address in exchange for a $10 shopping spree or gift certificate. Or if it's DM us to order, you know, letting people know that they can order from you on Instagram if they DM, or if it's stop in today and you're leaving your store address. So make sure that you have a call to action using emojis, sharing some of the products that you sell as well. You can even have on your bio, you could space down, like hit the return so it goes down to the next line and makes your bio a little bit bigger because you're using up that space versus just typing everything out. That's another great way. You could start each of those lines with a little emoji, almost like you're bulleting, to help it optimize and stand out. Another tip is we want to make sure that if you are using a branded hashtag for your store, share the branded hashtag in the bio, telling people to use that hashtag when they're talking about your store or things they bought from your store as well. And you also want to make sure that you're adding a website. So of course, if you sell online, you're linking over to your site for people to shop online. If you don't sell online, you could always use something like Linktree. So with Linktree, you can have several different links that are on there. They'll just click that link that's in your bio, and then if you want to take them to your blog or to your Facebook page to like you on Facebook, or maybe you're really active on Pinterest, or maybe you have that lead magnet that gets people to opt in to give the $10 savings. So you might have a lot of call to actions for people, and instead of always changing the link in your bio to reflect the post, and you've probably seen this, you're probably doing it, somebody will post on Instagram and they'll say, you know, check out our new arrivals, link is in the bio. Well, you have to go and like change the link in the bio to the new products link, whether that's on Facebook or on your site. And then your next post, you're talking about like a new blog post that you just wrote. And so then you have to go and change the link in the bio again. And so if you forget to change the link in the bio, it's a disconnect, right? It's not a great experience for your users. So with Linktree, you can have blog, new arrivals, Facebook page, whatever the different CTAs are that you have on each of your feeds. That's going to save you a lot of time and just create a better experience for people shopping with you and following you on Instagram. Another thing that you could use is LinkedIn or linkedin.bio. You could go, that's actually a website. And this is created through later.com, which allows your Instagram posts to be clickable and shoppable. Basically creates a landing page for your content on Instagram where people can then buy. This is a great option for e-commerce businesses, or if you're selling through on your shop tab on Facebook. So those are a few ideas, right? You can use, definitely have a website, whether it's your website, Linktree, link in bio, something like that. Finally, with the name field on Instagram, don't just have that be your business name. If you have enough space, enough characters, you can also add the type of product that you sell. So you are limited. You can only do 30 characters in the name field, but let's say that your store name is, I'm totally randomly creating something that it's something with babies, green babies, let's say. And then you could add in there eco baby supplies or eco baby toys or eco baby clothing. Those are keywords. So if people are searching for baby or clothing or eco or maybe organic or natural, whatever types of products you sell, if you've got that room, add in a keyword or two to describe the products you sell in the name field. So those are a few ideas on how to optimize your Instagram bio for your business profile. If you thought that this video was helpful and you want more tips, subscribe to my weekly newsletter, and I hope to see you in your inbox or on the next video.